So my topic is professionalism. Start small. Why do I say small? Because most of our older generation know what professionalism is. I hope so. And but the middle generation, the younger generation, is a big mouthful of a word. You might not really understand what it means. So when I was younger, I saw a movie called The Professionals. Gunslingers from a cowboy movie. They are professional assassins, professional people in all walks of life, like professional carpenters or plumbers or professional teachers, professional doctors. In our country, when we say professional, we used to think about doctors and engineers. That is not so. Everybody who works in some kind of profession is a professional, who earns their living from that specific type of job. That is a professional. A professional is somebody who thinks, who looks and acts like a professional. So when I say start small, very easy to start small because there are a lot of criteria, a lot of characteristics to make up a professional. Actually, it's a blend of many, many characteristics which are blended and integrated into a package to make you a professional. But it takes years of experience to become a professional. And our junior colleagues, students, house surgeons, young budding doctors will have to start small. And you have to, of course, acquire knowledge, technical knowledge, attitude, and skills. So many types of skills, including the soft skills. Soft skills like ethics, attitude, problem solving, self-confidence, optimism, enthusiasm, time management, so many other soft skills, networking, communication skills. You need a lot of skills. But then, to acquire all these skills take time and experience. But first of all, one of the very basic criteria is to give your best in your work, the quality of your work, and then the way you look, and to be punctual, and to have ethics. Punctuality is very important. Even students nowadays, when we go for lectures, the one who's going to give the lecture is already waiting for the students to arrive. Students come in straggling in. Teacher has to wait. So that is one point. And most of the time, and also in the high level, we have meetings. We have meetings, but sometimes, somehow, it doesn't start on time. But for ordinary, even like academic board meetings, not very high level, just the professors and heads or other meetings, sometimes we have to wait. I call it Myanmar Standard Time, Myanmar Sandoji. No, they don't come. You know, the meeting is sort of delayed. So punctuality, very important. The way you dress, also very important. It has to be appropriate. You're a doctor, you're a medical profession. We are still, at least in Myanmar, we are still conservative about the code of dress, the mode of dress. You can dress anyhow you like outside. But once you are in the job, once you are in the place of work, you have to dress appropriately or else the patients and the caregivers are not going to respect you. They expect professionalism. They expect their doctors to be professional, professionally dressed as well. And speaking about dress, it has to be decent. We don't want indecent exposure. There has been cases of indecent exposure among medical professionals. That is one aspect. We don't want that sort of indecent exposure in our noble profession. So anyway, punctuality, mode of dress, give the best, the quality of work, and also the soft skills, communication skills, etc. And can we teach professionalism? We can. Professionalism is knowing how to do it, when to do it, and doing it. I'm taking a quote from Frank Tiger. And remember that professionalism is the heart and soul of medicine. And patients look up to the doctors, the health personnel, to the doctors especially, to be professional. They trust the doctors. They place their trust in the doctors. They have confidence. If you don't look like a professional, if you don't act like a professional, how can you live up to your expectations, to their expectations? And the other thing is we can teach professionalism to the younger generation, to the students, in the form of informal hidden curricula. We can teach them in hidden curricula, part of the hidden curricula, informal, formal type of curricula. Also, role modeling. Role modeling is very important. If you do not act professionally, how can you expect your students or your juniors to be professional? If you look at this structure, the roof, overarching roof, is the professionalism, and the pillars, the main four pillars, of course there are many more. Excellence. You strive for excellence, you do your best, you to be competent doctors. Humanism. Empathy. You need empathy. You need to put yourself in the shoes of the patient, the slippers of the patient or the caregiver. Would you like your near and dear to be treated thus? You wouldn't. So you have to have empathy and also sincerity, honesty, accountability, responsibility. All these make up a professional. Altruism, that means for self as well as for others. In Myanmar, we say atanepara. Of course, you've got to earn a living, you've got to look out for yourself as well, but then you've got to think of the whole population. And professionalism also includes communication. Nowadays, sometimes, because like all the others have been saying, we are short of human resources. The same human resources are deployed in the public sector as well as the private sector. We do not have enough specialists to go around, and then they are short of time. They are short of time. They have to run from one place to the other. Sometimes they do not have the time to explain, to communicate to the patient and the caregivers. And this causes some legal problems. Nowadays, we are having a lot of legal problems, but communication is very important. We need good communication skills and also sound ethics. Professional ethics, teacher's ethics, research ethics, you name it. So many ethics. And we have to be careful to avoid conflict of interest. So accountability, responsibility, don't put the blame on others. You have to have responsibility. And of course, communication skills, clinical competence, knowledge skills, attitude, etc. So can we teach professionalism? We can. Like I said, like informal, formal curricula, hidden curricula, role modeling, very important, and also continuing professional development, or what we call CBD. In fact, some countries are advocating CBD, continuing professional development, is even more important than continuous medical education, CME, because professional development, what do you mean by professional development? It goes lifelong. You do not stop at one point. You go on learning. And then back in 2003, the World Federation for Medical Education defined continuing professional development as activities that doctors undertake to upgrade, maintain, enhance their skills, the technical skills, all the soft skills, etc., their skills and their attitude and their knowledge in response to the health needs of the country. So continuing professional development is lifelong, and like the boat club used to say, row till you are dead. We keep on learning, not only knowledge and skills, but attitude, and then a lot of soft skills as well. And this is becoming very important, because right now we do not have CME or CBD for relicensing, revalidation of the license. Myanmar Medical Council is responsible for registration and licensing of newly graduated doctors, as well as we are now giving out specialist registration. So in other countries, we have two ASEAN meetings for the councils, Medical Council, Dental Council, Nursing and Midwifery Council, twice a year. And they used to say, why does Myanmar not have a process for revalidation? We are sort of giving out automatic relicensing every 3 years. This should not be. But our defect is that before we did not have internet access countrywide. And then not all doctors, especially those in the remote areas, they did not have a chance to attend medical conferences or talks or, you know, events to upgrade their knowledge, skills and attitude. And all the big conferences were held in the big cities like Mandalay, Yangon, Mandalay, Maulmin, etc. But now the Myanmar Medical Association have gone out to all parts of the country, and also they have distributed CDs of all the talks to all doctors. So now, in the very near future, soon to come, is revalidation by credit points based on continuing professional development, or CME. And this will be soon practiced very soon by the Myanmar Medical Council, so it is very important for CBD. Another thing is, the little thing I want to touch about is social media. Now that Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, social media is open to all, I find that there is use and abuse of the social media by doctors, by laymen, by everybody. And as professional doctors, we should maintain the confidentiality of the identity of the patients. We should not downgrade or post news, negative news, or post photographs, or share even with the public on our doctors, our peers, our colleagues. That is an ethical issue. So I would like to give a sort of a, not a warning, it's not my place to give a warning, but just a note for you to consider. Facebook is not to post negative things about patients, about fellow professionals, and about the whole system in general. And we are having, well, I want you to remember that professionalism, I repeat again, is the heart and soul of medicine. And whatever it is, the take-home message is, the common thing is best. You give your best, you speak your best, you listen your best, you dress your best. Your dress best means not to have gold and jewelry and expensive clothes. To dress appropriately as a doctor. Dress your best, give your best, live your best, and learn continuously. So, in conclusion, I would like to say that there are so many criteria to become a professional. In fact, it is not one criteria, it is a whole package. And you cannot acquire them all at once. It will come to you as the years go by experience. You cannot be perfect at once. You will acquire them by experience, by long years of working, and as also working as a team with your colleagues. So whatever the criteria, whatever the package of qualities that you need to be a professional, all these are just song. It depends on you. So therefore, it is the singer, not the song. Thank you.